Hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create one amazing Arduino project with MIT App Inventor app. It means in this project we are going to control one LED light with the help of one Android app, okay? And that Android app we will create using MIT App Inventor. That's the block based coding language, okay? So it's really simple and basic. So let me show you a step by step how we can do this and how we can complete this project. So here we go. So what we need here, we required some components. Like first is Arduino UNO. This is the Arduino UNO, okay? Second, we need one cable that can connect with your Arduino and with USB port. USB port and then Arduino, okay? Third, we need a Bluetooth module. This is the Bluetooth module, okay? I'll give you the all details of that module in the description. Now, we need one simple small LED light like this one, okay? So we can turn on this and turn off using our phone. We need some jumper wire, female and male, okay? First of all, what I will do, I will use my Arduino UNO first here, okay? And now I'm going to connect this Arduino UNO, okay, with my Bluetooth module, okay? So what I will do here, I have to just connect this one to here. Now as you can see here five values, okay? So let me just tell you that, like, see these values, TERX, TX, ZND and plus 5 volt. So what I will do, I will just connect that first wire, okay, first, and I will connect with this RX, okay, RX, and then I will connect this one to here, to the TX. As you can see here, as you can see the pin 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, right? So what I recently connected RX, okay? Now I will connect this to the TX. Make sure this is to TX, RX, and then here TX, okay? Now second wire, you can use any color of wire. There's no issue with color. So I'll connect again with the TX, okay? First RX, then TX. And I will connect that TX wire to the RX. Okay, so as you can see here, there's one space here, this one. So this is the RX. Okay, it means you have to just connect by opposite, like RX to TX, TX to RX. Okay, as you can see, the white one is RX and his white one is TX. Okay, good. Now, in the third one, you have to connect with this ZND, ground it means. Okay, so let's just connect this to the ground like this. And we need to connect this one is also to the ground. As you can see this side pin, you can see here the 5 volt and ZND, and that ZND wire goes to the ZND, this one, ZND to ZND. Now let's again, one more wire is the 5 volt like this. Connect this 5 volt and this should be connect to the 5 volt, same, right here. Now what I need to do, I need to connect my cable like this one here, okay, like this. I need to connect this USB port with my laptop, okay? And as you can see, the Bluetooth module is connected. Now as you can see the light, if the light is running fast like this, it means the Bluetooth is not connected. Once you connect to your Bluetooth, the light will slow down their blinking. Now I need to connect this LED light, okay? How can I connect this? So make sure that is small one, as you can see we have a small one and the longer one, see this wire. So the small one goes to the ZND and the longer one is goes to the 13 pin. Done. Now let's focus on how we can write a code for Arduino. Make sure before uploading the code you have to remove both wire, which one, TX and RX. Remove that wire, upload your Arduino code, connect this and run your code. Okay, do this. So we already have set up our Arduino and Bluetooth device. Now what we need to do, we need to write a code for Arduino. So how we can do this? So first of all, we need to download Arduino IDE. Okay, so just search here Arduino IDE, okay, and open that, download and install Arduino IDE. Click on this. Now you can install like if you have Mac, then you can install this, Windows or for Linux. Okay, after installing the software, it will look like this. I already have that. As you can see, that's the software. Okay, and
Once you open this, you will see the default code is simple void setup and void loop, only two functions. But that code we have to write. It's really very basic code. Let me just explain you what that code is. As you can see, we have defined the character incoming value equal 0. It means we have defined one variable and that we have assigned the value to 0. Okay. Now, in that void setup function, serial.begin. We have used here 9600 port and we use your pin mode. It means which pin we have used. Okay. Like you can use 12, 11, any other pin also, but we already have used 13 pin. Okay. As I have mentioned before. And as you can see the output, because we are using here LED light. Okay. We are giving the output. Okay. This code will give us the output. That's why we use their output keyword. Okay. So we have to define here the port number. Okay. In the pin mode, we have to define the port number, unit pin number and the mode. Okay. Now, as you can see in the loop, incoming value equal, it means that we have defined variable incoming value. We are getting the serial dot read. It means this will read the value that incoming from that, from the Bluetooth. Okay. So as you can see, serial dot read. Once that value received, so we have to check that value is 1 or 0, because we will write that value, we will send that value from our phone. Okay, so we'll check that condition. If incoming value is equal to 1, then digital write, W is capital here, make sure be careful about the, you know, capital and small letter, digital write 13 is our pin mode, right? And the high means your LED light will turn on. Okay, this is the high. And as you can see, the else if the incoming value is double equal to 0, then digital write 13 port. Okay, this one. And the value is low. Low means 0. It means nothing. Whenever we send the value 0, then turn light will turn off. And whenever we send the value 1, then light will turn on. So how we can send that value? We are going to use your Bluetooth. Okay. We will connect our phone. Okay. With Arduino to send that text. Okay. And how we can do this? So we are going to write very simple code in MIT App Inventor app. Okay. So this is the code. Now what we need to, after writing this code, you need to just click on compile this one. Okay. And then you need to click on that upload button. Make sure, be careful. First, please don't attach your Bluetooth device with Arduino. Okay. As you can see, we are getting here is like, you know, failed uploading, no port provided, right? Because we don't provide that code. So what I will do, I will just provide one port here. I will just connect Arduino only, nothing, there is no Bluetooth device right now. Okay, so just connect it. I have to just select the Arduino UNO. Yes, done. Then just compile it. Okay, it's compiling. And then just click on upload and you will get the message of uploaded, like, see, uploading, compile, done compiling, and wait, uploading, see, done uploading. Okay, this is my Bluetooth device. After uploading the code, I will just connect that all my wires, okay, with Bluetooth mode to Arduino. Okay, after uploading code. Now let's, this is done. Now let's connect your Bluetooth. Okay, this step. And after this, we are going to now, let's move to the MIT App Inventor app, where we need to create an app that can send the signal to our Arduino board to turn on the light or off. It means we have to send 1 or 0 from our app. So how we can do this? So it's very simple. First of all, you need to log into ai2.appinventor.mit.edu. This is the MIT App Inventor website where we are going to create app. It's totally free of cost. Okay. Now you have to log in. Okay. I already have logged in. So let's click on start new project and my project name is LED light new and okay. Okay, that's my app name. You can define any app name. Okay, now let's wait some seconds. As you can see, that's the screen here, right? Now what we need to do, we need to use here some component. It's like we need three component. One is list picker, okay, to get a Bluetooth list. Okay, so let's, I'll use your width is 90% like this. Okay, I will click on this screen and I'll just make this in the center like this. Now I'm going to use your one button, this one, and I'm going to use another button. Now as you can see, this is the button one. So what I will do, I'll just here, so what I'm going to do here, I'm going to use here one on, turn on light or something on something. Okay, and I'll make this width is like 50% or 70% something, okay, like this. And height is, I'm going to make it at least 20%, like this. Okay, oh, it's too much, so I will just define to 15% is fine. Okay, and I will change the background color of this to the green, like this, and change that font size to the 30, like this. Okay, and another button, I will just make this one is also the 70%, like this, and I will define that text to the off, and I'll make this background color to the red. I will make that text color to be the white, like this, and I'll make that also font size 30%. Okay, and I'll make this height is also 50%, like this. Cool. So this is on and off, and this is for select Bluetooth or something. So I'll just say connect or disconnect. So I'll just say choose connection something. Okay, so once you click on this, so you will get the list of Bluetooths. Okay, and you have to click on this. Once you click on this, so this will we can use here to check the Bluetooth is device is connected or not. Okay, this is our simple design. Now let's go to the block. Okay, wait a second, go to the design. Make sure in the left side you will find their connections. Okay, wait a second, connectivity, and as you can see the Bluetooth client. Make sure we just need to just drag and drop that. This is the most important component, because using this component, we are going to send the 0 or 1 value to our Arduino. Okay, now let's go to the block here. Now what I will do here, let's go to the list picker. Okay, when list picker before picking. Okay, so let's click on list picker. And as you can see, before picking this one, we need to set element, it means Bluetooth device in this list. So how we can do this, just click on list picker again, and as you can see the list picker dot elements. So as you can see the set list picker dot element, just drag and drop this here, and then we need to click on the Bluetooth device, and we need to find the address. So click on Bluetooth client, and you will find the Bluetooth client dot address and name. Okay, so you'll see here address and name component here, this one, as you can see this one, just drag and drop this here, like here. Okay, now just here. Okay, now what we need to do here is done after picking we have to set this, right? So let's again click on list picker, and you will see here list picker after picking. Okay, so suppose we have Arduino HC-05, so after selecting the HC-05 we have to set this value, right? So list picker dot selection, so I'll just copy paste this. And I'll just change this element to the selection, list picker dot selection. And here I need to get the Bluetooth device name, so client name. And you will see here the option is, see, as you can see the call connect dot address. Okay, this connect, and the address is list picker dot selection. Okay, so list picker dot selection, this one. Right, now what we need to do here, we need to set list picker dot text as connected. Okay, so after connecting this, right, this one, and I'm going to use the one text blank, just drag and drop this here, and I'll just say here connected. Okay, now once I click on the button one, okay, so what I need to do, I need to send the data. Okay, and what I need to do, I need to send the 0 to turn off or turn on. So how can I do this? So as you can see, go to the design. As you can see, this is the button one. It means once I click on this, I need to send the 1 value, because on that 1 we have to turn on our light. As you can see in the Arduino is 1. Once the 1 is, then high, it means turn on. So let's click on the button one. So once I click on this button one, so I need to send the data to the Bluetooth. So click on Bluetooth client, and you will see here the option of send text. Okay, receive text, send text, this one, just call it here. Okay, and just copy this, and I'm gonna send the here is one, like this. Okay, and for the button 2, just copy paste, and I'm going to send to 0 to turn off this. That's it. That's the simple code we have to write to connect Arduino. Now we need to, what we need to do, we need to click on build option, and generate the APK. And now we need to install that APK in our Android phone. So I'm going to install this APK on my Android phone, and let's see how this will work. Okay,
so as you can see here, that's our app that we just created. Okay, and that's our Bluetooth module, and that's our Arduino. Okay, now as you can see here, that light, Bluetooth module light, is blinking very fast. It means this module is not connected, this Bluetooth module not connected to any Bluetooth device. Now what I'm going to do here, I'm going to open my Bluetooth here, okay, and let's see, wait some seconds to find that Bluetooth module. So as you can see here, HC-05. Okay, now let's connect to this. As you can see, the pair device, so the password is always the 1234000. So I'm going to use 1234 and let's pair it, and it's now connected. Good. Now let's go to the pair device. Now let's go to the app here. Okay, now as you can see, choose connection, click on this. As you can see, the device, and let's click on connection and wait some second. Now see, connected. Now as you can see, the light, blinking light, is very slow. This will just blink in very few seconds, right? So it means that module is connected to our phone. Now let's see on and off. Let's click on the on, that's the LED light here. Let's click on. It's on, off, on, off. My phone is not connected to this, right? I'm controlling this with my phone. That LED light I'm controlling with my phone. On, off, on, off. That's amazing app that we have created.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. If you have some idea, so just comment on the video. I'll try to build that idea, and I will connect that Arduino with MIT App Inventor with the other projects. So please suggest me some more ideas. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.